Good morning, Eagle Nation, and happy Friday. Today is the 24th of February. It's the 122nd day of school and the 33rd day in this third quarter. Please join me in starting our Friday off with just a moment of silence. Thank you. And now, your Friday song.
When you and the team are pitching a new prop.
Grammarly, honestly, here we go. Stand, and let's say this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. Please join me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated because it's a Friday, which means we rest our bodies but not our minds until the end. We got a full day today, a few absences. Mr. Nelson is out. Ms. Wu is out. Ms. Gabriela Garcia is out and Vanessa Sarabia is out, but all others are here. Mr. Schiffman is on campus today and we are grateful for that. No matter how it plays out, we will work together to get the job done for you, our students. Thank you teachers in advance and staff members and instructional assistants and supporting staff for continuing to work together always to give our kids whatever it is they need to be their best version of themselves and to succeed. We'll keep doing it every day. Thank you. What's going on? We bring to a close, in some ways, Black History Month by preparing for our trivia next week. So next week we'll do 5 days of trivia. We'll do it as we've always done. I encourage you to take a chance with your classmates or with your students to review what you know there, maybe during SEL time this morning or maybe during SEL time in the afternoon. You have a chance to quiz each other about who those individuals are that we have celebrated this month, so we can play the game next week. I will slowly be removing the scaffolds to see as the questions get harder throughout the week, so be ready for that. This morning there is a cafecito going on right now at 8:30 in Ms. Robbins's room with many of our parents. Tomorrow from 9 to 10 there will be another cafecito that will be purely in Spanish for our Spanish-speaking families. So we hope that your families, if they haven't come in the past, come to join us. It's open to all, but we will be presenting in Spanish tomorrow and in English today. Both of those are open to all. We have begun the process for the comprehensive needs assessment, which means students, it's always important to stop, reflect on your progress, evaluate if you need to make adjustments, and then make a plan for the future. Well, your leadership team at Emerson began doing that yesterday, and they're gonna do it on at least two more occasions in the coming weeks, where we reflect on what we've accomplished this year, what still needs to be accomplished, and what plan we need to put in place for the year ahead when you come back to us in the 23-24 school year. So to all of you, stay tuned for what will be in that plan, the reflections that were shared in that room, were a rich conversation and lots of great insights to what's going on across your campus. So be sure that you have the ear of one of your leadership team members because they're exercising their voice and your voice by proxy. Attendance yesterday was 90.2%. 90.2. It's good. It's not great. It's good. It's over 90%. It's not great, but it's good. Our overall for the year was 89%. So not significant progress. Kind of holding steady. I think we could do better. I know we could do better. If I'm talking about you individually, can you do better? The answer is yes, but maybe you need support. Reach out. Talk to your teacher. Talk to your parents or guardians. Let's get you here daily and on time. I would like to do two shout-outs today on this Friday. So listen in and listen up, students and teachers alike. This first one is to you, Mr. Conway. Thank you for always creating a joyful, vibrant space for your students to thrive. Your relationships with kids are strong and positive, and you inspire me every day. Thank you, Mr. Conway. And thank you, Ms. Greenberg, for that shout out. Additionally, we'd like to shout out Ms. Hernandez. Ms. Hernandez has been a great addition to our Emerson community. We are grateful that she has graciously taken over fifth and sixth grade in order to keep the learning going. Thank you, Ms. Hernandez. That is from Mr. Aviles. And thank you, Mr. Aviles, for that shout out. We'll do one more today. This one goes to you, Ms. Swank, our school psychologist. Ms. Swank, if you're listening, you are such a kind and amazing colleague. I know that anyone can call on you for support, whether it to be a listening ear or helping in the classroom. Thank you. And that was also from Ms. Greenberg. So today, Mr. Conway, Ms. Swank, and Ms. Hernandez, we salute you. We are grateful for all that you do for our kids and for our teachers and staff every day. Let's make it a great Friday today. Before we go, let's get to the words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. And today is on the topic of making friends. Dale Carnegie was a famous writer and a public speaker. He was especially famous for helping people who want to do their very best. He wrote a book called How to Win Friends and Influence People, and it sold over 10 million copies in different languages around the world. Listen to what he had to say more than 60 years ago. He said, "You can make more friends in 2 months by becoming interested in other people than you can in 2 years by trying to get other people to be interested in you." So if you want to make friends, start off being a good friend to others. Listen to them. Show you care when they have problems. Show you're interested in what's going on in their lives. If you want to make new friends, remember Mr. Carnegie's words and reach out to others. As I'm feeling ill today, I want to protect you and others. So I encourage you all with something to think about. This is Mr. Lodato. I encourage you today to mask up as needed. Hand sanitize regularly because all kinds of stuff going around. Hats, hoods, and sunglasses off indoors. Stay in your zones. Put away your phones. And make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.
Collaborate and listen. I sit back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tight and flow like a